One evening, Steve and George were on their way back to the yard after a long day of work. They were still discussing to each other about what the future held for the diesels across the country.
You know, I'm just relieved that Cora didn't end up at LaGrange like most of her sisters did. But how am I going to tell her about the fate that they met?
I don't know, to be honest. I think it's a cruel irony for us, though. We replaced the steam locomotives on all the other railroads, and now many diesels like us are getting put in their shoes.
Really, I am. You and your siblings didn't come along until after a few years after all the railroads had retired their steam power. It's my type that sent them to their doom.
Before they could think of anything else to say, they had arrived at the yards and were met with a huge surprise. Many of the workers were washing the windows on the shed. Anthony was getting greased all over to ensure that he was working as well as the clock, and behind Katie sat a slope-back tender that had been repainted green to match a livery. They were very surprised.
Katie? Where did that tender behind you come from?
It was a gift. Mr. Winston told me that he bought it a few years back in secrecy, with the intention to fix it up and hand it over to me, mainly so I could have a larger water capacity than I had before.
Huh. That's a nice treat. But I don't get it. You've never had that many issues with fuel before while running on the line.
Yes, but he also said he had more excursions planned for us.
More excursions? Whatever for?
Hold your horses, George. He's about to tell us.
Good evening, my engines. I think you all have noticed I've been having an increase in excursions, outings, and events like railroad days recently. And now you have all seen that I've been making improvements in the yard itself. I think it's time I finally explained a plan I have for a railroad's future. I'm opening a museum. It will be run as a non-profit by volunteers, and many of you, particularly the steam engines, will become part of this museum's collection. This will make it easier to keep you all in working order without interfering with the times. But don't think you'll lose your jobs on this railroad. You will still be able to run excursions with full permission, and you will still pull freight whenever you are needed. I would also like to announce the first excursion for when this museum opens. When 2904 is done, he will be doing a double header with you, Vincent. Take it as a reward for your hard work, and most importantly, the fact that you were the one who found him in the first place.
Really, sir? I'm quite honored. Though, I don't know if I'm worthy.
Oh, of course you're worthy, Vincent. Like I just said, you're the one who found him in the first place. That is all I have for you tonight. Please get some rest. We still have a rail to run in the meantime.
Although Vincent was flattered that Mr. Winston wanted him to doublehead with 2904, he didn't believe he deserved it after what had happened to 1617. Yes, I'm sorry to say, Vincent was still feeling a sense of guilt. While Mr. Winston was away, he began to ask other engines if they were willing to take his place.
Vincent, take a good look at me. What am I?
A hard worker?
No! Well, yes, but I'm also a 260 mogul. I'm not exactly suitable for mainline excursions like that. Why would you want to pass it to someone else anyway? Don't tell me. Vincent, you seriously need to get over 1617. Who's going to care about an RS3 when we have the only surviving Chicago Northwest of 462 being restored to operation anyway?
Why do I even bother with you? I'm just gonna ask someone else.
Yeah, good luck with that.
So Vincent tried asking Nick or Andrew next.
I don't think I'll be able to, I'm afraid. Now that my tires have been refitted, I need to catch up on my work. There's a lot of freight that has been needed to be transported recently.
But this excursion is important.
I know, but so is keeping the regular trains rolling. Don't get me wrong, I'd love to. It's just, You know, I don't think I can. I'm hoping I can be there to watch you set off, but I just don't have time to do the full thing.
Andrew, what about...
Don't even think about it.
Andrew, please. Look, I know fan trips aren't your thing, but I really think you do a much better job than me. I don't deserve it anyway.
What? Why don't you think you deserve it?
Because I was responsible for sending 1617 to his death. And Mr. Winston has the audacity to act like I'm a hero for saving 2904. If anything, I'm a bigot.
All right. Fine. I'm sorry. I'll help out for you. But I want to make sure, Vincent. Would one of us taking your place in this excursion make you happy?
It's not about making me happy. It's about avenging 1617.
All right. If Mr. Winston is okay with it, I'll do it. You have the excuse of caring about the deceased. I'm just being a stubborn mule. I think it's time I give fan trips another chance. Maybe I'll like it this time.
It wasn't long before 2904 had his first steam test. He couldn't go out onto the main line just yet, but he did do paces across the yard to iron out any hiccups. Katie and Anthony were also there, and soon the three started chatting.
I was wondering, 2904, has Mr. Winston given you a name yet?
I don't think he has. You think I should get one?
Well, of course. We'd never let an engine on this railway without giving them a name. Any names you'd like to have?
Let me think. You know, two I've been thinking of are John or Alan. How's that sound?
What do you think of Simon? I had a good friend named Simon who helped save my life. So that would be one way to honor him.
Or even Paul. I don't think that name would really suit you, though.
I agree. And to be honest, Simon's a nice name, but I already have one in mind.
You do?
Yes. When I was very young, my father took me on the Flambeau 400. It was one of the first passenger trains that I have a distinct memory of riding. It was being pulled by a 462, just like you, 2904.
Well, sir, you know... Maybe it was me.
You never know. But that memory has been kept with me for a very long time, and one of the fondest I've ever had. And that's why I want to name you after my father, 2904. How do you like the name Max?
You know, I dig that. I really, really do.
That name would make a great honor to your father, sir.
Glad you think so, Anthony. So, Max... It shall be.
Hello, sir. I wanted to talk to you about the debut excursion with 2904.
Whoa, just call me Max from now on, all right?
My apologies. You finally have a name now?
Yes, sir, and I'll have it with honor.
All right, so Mr. Winston, I wanted to let you know that Vincent doesn't want to do the excursion.
What? Why?
He has a bad squeak on some of his side rods.
Yeah, like I'm going to fall for that. That could be greased.
He asked me if I could take his place on this excursion, and I said yes.
I knew I shouldn't have put so much sugar in my coffee this morning. You, of all engines, want to take over?
Yep. I've decided to give fan trips another chance. Any objections?
No, as long as he promised me you'll do a good job.
Of course I will.
Thank you.
Just a few minutes, Andy. I gotta get some coaches into the cleaning shed, and I'll be right over.
No, don't bother. I'll do it myself, Emily.
Andrew, it'll just be a few minutes.
That's still too long.
Andrew, wait! The switch is on!
But it was too late.
You imbecile! I told you to wait! Now you've messed up the yard!
I just wanted to keep things rolling.
Mr. Winston soon came to inspect the damage.
Well, one thing's for sure, Andrew. This'll put you out of commission for a while, which won't do for the excursion. I'll have to make some changes.
It's fine. I suppose I deserve this.
Vincent, you're going to have to do the doubleheader after all. I don't understand why you asked Andrew to take over in the first place.
But...
No buts. This excursion was meant for you and Max. Treasure it, because this is how I want it to be.
Good afternoon, Charlie.
Steve. Andrew's had an accident, and Vincent's been whining non-stop about that stupid RS3 that got scrapped recently. How is it a good afternoon?
Stupid? Charlie, show some compassion. I know it gets...
I get it. But come on. Is he blind to the fact that he also saved the only survivor in Chicago of Western Pacific? And RS3s are pretty much a dime a dozen? Give me a...
Charlie, just listen to me for a moment. As one of the oldest diesels around here, I remember a time when steam locomotives were seen as, you know, a dime a dozen. When I was new to the Santa Fe, there were steam locomotives everywhere. I saw Mikados, Northerns, Texas types, Santa Fe types, you name it. But only 10 years later, where they almost completely wiped off the face of the earth.
I mean, that's why steam locomotives are valued more now.
And it probably won't be long before older diesels like me, Emily, Jerry, 1617, heck, even George, become just as rare. All I'm trying to say is, even if what we run on is different, we're all valuable in our own way.
You're right. I told Vincent to get over it.
Yeah, you did. And I think you should apologize to him the next time you see him.
I won't just do that. I'll make sure Mr. Winston knows about the diesel issue you just brought up to me. I remember when I was taken for granted on the CN.
That night, Vincent was still trying to think about the best way to move on from 1617. He had no idea, though, that he was about to get his answer.
It's you.
Yes, it is me.
Please, don't haunt me. Listen, I'm really sorry for what happened. I've been feeling guilty ever since. I should have figured out that you yourself were in danger.
It's, Vincent, it's not your fault. It's really mine, honestly. I shouldn't have beat around the bush. I should have told you directly that I was a refugee. But I must ask, how did you find out about 2904?
I'll put it in the shortest way possible. When I went into the Northwestern, right after you told me there was an engine you knew that needed a good home, I found him by mistake. Some freight cars rolled onto a branch line he was sitting on, and I had to go and retrieve them. That's where I end up finding 2904. I wanted to rescue him right away, but it may have to come to a cost since I almost got reported for stealing a Northwestern engine. I don't know if I can entirely blame him, given I don't even know who owned him.
Well, I wouldn't say it was stealing. I gather David J. Joseph told you that they had no records of purchasing him?
Yes. Why do you ask?
That's because they never bought him to begin with! 2904 was meant to go to the Northwestern Steel and Wire. I'm honestly surprised that they never even tried to look for him.
Excuse me?
Oh boy, do I have a story for you. It was me who tried to save him. I have always admired steam locomotives. Contrary to popular belief, the steam engines on the Chicago and Northwestern were quite nice to us, and showed us how to run the railroad alongside. But I soon realized that after I was built, the C&W wasn't making a big effort to preserve any of the remarkable steam locomotives. I mean, sure, they did save an Atlantic and a few R1s, but I towed dozens of H-classes, Mikados, and even E4s to various scrapyards across the Midwest. I hated it. As in my eyes, they didn't deserve it. I tried to save a few of them before being scrapped, but all of my attempts failed and landed me in serious trouble. But this only got me to smarten up. I was far from the only diesel who ever felt this way too, so I formed an alliance with a few other diesels I knew from other railroads, such as the New York Central, the Illinois Central, and the Milwaukee Road. I made several attempts to save various steam engines, including 2904. Most of them failed, but 2904 was the only attempt from the C&W that actually succeeded. When I got word that all of the C&W E2s were being sent away for scrap, my fellow sympathizers and I knew what to do, and we settled on saving 2904 because he was in the best shape of all the class. So, thanks to us pulling a few strings, I had some workers on the C&W write up some false paperwork, saying that 2904 was meant to go to David J. Joseph's and Company's scrapyard in Cincinnati, despite the fact that they never actually bought him in the first place. It was all just to the end of me getting him off the Northwestern and leading the Northwestern's higher-ups on a wild goose chase that resulted in me shoving him onto the end of an abandoned branch line, where we thought they'd never even think to look. And to my surprise, it worked! They never found him. They've gave up looking for him, and they eventually lost interest in getting him back.
You cheeky git!
After 1960, the craze soon ended too. Most of the engines we saved were in good homes now, but I did my best to keep a close eye on all the engines we tried to save. All of them ended up in museums or even city parks. Except 2904. 2904 was the last engine I kept an eye on. I was determined to help him find a good home. I wouldn't have gone to all this trouble just to leave him there at the end of the branch line. But eventually, time soon caught up with me too. Just a couple of months ago, the Northwestern had planned to retire RS3s like me, and I was going to be sent to the LaGrange scrapyard in Chicagoland. LaGrange doesn't mess around when it comes to scrapping diesel and electric locomotives. When engines go in there, they almost never come back in one piece. I knew I was in danger, so I tried to get back in contact with my allies. But most of them had been retired or even scrapped. I tried to hide for a little while, but eventually I remembered that one of my old friends, Emily, had now become a part of your railroad. So I attempted to reach out to her, and sure enough, she agreed to help me take cover here. It was a win-win, I thought at first, given I knew that 2904 wasn't far away, and that I could check on him every so often to see how he was doing. That being said, I knew it wouldn't last for long, given that Northwestern diesels came on the railway frequently, and were sure to see me. I'm surprised I wasn't sent back sooner.
I see.
But the good news is, thanks to you, my mission is complete.
Really?
Yes. I'm still happy that 2904 has been given a new home, and that I could go to the afterlife peacefully,
knowing that every last steam locomotive I've attempted to save all those years ago has found a new home. So, thank you, Vincent, for still helping me. Even if you didn't realize it at first.
You're welcome.
I just wanted to let you know I'm not mad, and I wanted to explain myself too.
Will I be seeing you again?
I'm not sure. Time will tell. I'll put it this way. I'll be here if you need me. So for now, I wish you the best of luck. Catch you on the flip side.
Thanks.
Next morning, as Vincent was steaming up and getting ready for the day, he was greeted by a face he had seen not long ago.
Oh, it's you.
I know you're not happy to see me, but I brought some stuff for you.
What do you mean, stuff?
Parts of that 2904 engine you guys rescued.
Oh, really? Thanks, I guess?
No sweat. I actually heard about the work you were doing on him from a few colleagues, and even saw some pictures in a magazine of the progress. I gotta admit, your restoration team has been doing a good job so far.
Well, don't compliment me. Compliment them.
Yeah. I guess it was a bit foolish of me to think that the Northwestern would care about 2904 at this point. He seems better off here.
Ah, I see you've smartened up.
Yeah, I guess. Well, here are your supplies. I've got to be going now.
Don't you have anything else to say before you go?
No? What makes you think that?
Don't you want to say, I'm sorry?
About what? Never mind that. I need to get going. Bye, Vince. Congratulations again on 2904.
You were this close.
Ah. Good morning, Vincent. I just wanted to give you the assignments for the phrase today.
Actually, sir, I changed my mind. I do want to doublehead with Max on the excursion. I'm sorry I've been so miserable for the past few weeks.
Thank goodness. But I just want to know, why did you want Andrew to take your place on the excursion? You know he's not crazy about fan trips.
I didn't think I deserved to be part of it, due to what happened to 1617.
I should have known. Vincent, I know you feel guilty about 1617, but I want this experience to be a treat for you. I'm sure 1617 will understand either way. And besides, I'm sure there's plenty of other RSVs still in existence.
Oh, he really does understand, sir. He really does.
How do you know that?
I just have a good feeling.
I see. Vincent, may I talk to you?
You want to give me more scrap for
it? No. Actually, Vincent, I want to apologize about what I said the other day. I hadn't thought about how diesels are starting to end up in the same amount of dangers as steam engines like us once were. Can you please accept my apology?
Of course. I appreciate that you've been coming to your senses recently.
Yeah. And while we're on that subject, I wanted to talk to you about this, Mr. Winston. The scrapping of that Chicago Northwestern RS3 has shook up all the diesels here. They're concerned for the future of their colleagues, since it won't be long before some diesels become as old as we were when we were retired. Can you please keep this in mind? I've always kept it in mind, you two. but I also wanted to make sure I could facilitate something that could help all of the seamans like yourselves stay saved. I learned recently that Sakal, Burlington, and Quincy Northern got cut up 2 years ago, which shocked me. I just want to do my best to make sure that doesn't happen again. You are all still valuable, after all.
We appreciate it, sir. I just can't wait to see where this new museum goes.
Same here. Now that we've settled things, I think we should now get ready for the museum's grand opening.
The night of the ceremony had finally come. Max had had his test runs, of course, but this was to be his first revenue run on the railway. Well, man, this is it.
This is it indeed.
Good luck. I'm gonna go check on Steve and Katie.
Nice to actually talk to you at last.
Oh, hello there. Think I've seen you around. Why haven't we spoken before?
I was just afraid you'd ignore me like almost everyone else does. I'm Emily, by the way. I myself am an ex-Chicago Northwestern engine just like you.
Really? You know, I do think I saw some SW1s back in service. Like you. Maybe we met once, didn't even know each other.
Yeah, small world. But at least we can get to know each other now.
Yeah, indeed. Actually, it's real nice to see another Northwesterner up here. We ought to chat one of these days.
Definitely! Good luck on your first run!
Why were you so skeptical about doing this excursion at first?
It's a long story. Nick? Buddy! It's good to see you! I thought you couldn't make it.
I was able to get a Burlington Northern Jeep to cover for me. I really didn't want to miss out. I'm glad to see you're feeling better, too.
For sure. You better grab a seat in the sheds, though. Mr. Winston wants a clear path for us.
Thanks for letting me know.
As Nick was looking for a spot, Mr. Winston quickly moved to the other side of the yard to talk to Kyle, who was inspecting Steve.
Hey Kyle, I wanted to make an offer to you.
Oh? What is it, Uncle?
So I have to ask you, do you enjoy working for my railroad?
Of course. I probably would have looked for another job by now if I didn't.
Great. Because when I retire, I want you to have it.
Really?
Yes. If you want to take over, that is. One of the main reasons I started the museum in the first place was so that every seaman in here, Hank, Charlie, Vincent, Katie, Anthony, Nick, Andrew, and now Max, can have a secure home in case something were to happen surrounding the main road. Though someone's got to take care of these guys when I can't do it anymore. That's why I want to offer the role to you when my time comes.
You really mean it, Uncle?
Yes. Because now, they're not just my engines. They're my friends.
Yeah. And they're my friends, too. I'll accept it.
Thanks, buddy. You're the best nephew an uncle could have.
I don't mean to interrupt, but could I quickly ask you something too, sir?
I'm listening, George.
We heard that Emily moved Jake recently. Where was he moved to?
Oh, that. I'm sorry, I didn't explain earlier. I sold him to a rail museum in Green Bay, Wisconsin. I did have to give them strict instructions not to give him those traction motors. But they said they'd just display him anyway, and plan to give it a cosmetic restoration. I'm praying that he'll have a better life there than he did here.
My word, sir. You really do care about all of us.
Like I just said to Kyle, you're not just my engines, you're my friends. I better get ready to board the train, though. Our ride awaits.
As all of the rail fans and tourists boarded the train, Mr. Winston soon made an announcement to them, the engines, and trackside photographers.
Ladies, gentlemen, and engines, you have all been enjoying seeing my engines in service since I made the decision not to dieselize, not to switch to the newest thing like the Class 1s. And now, you have a chance to embrace it yourself. As of tonight, I now declare the Fairway Transportation Museum open!
Everyone went silent at that moment. Then the two engines blew their whistles as long and loudly as possible for everyone to hear, and they soon set off for the railway's first ever excursion. Engines, both steam and diesel, blew their whistles and horns so loud it could be heard from miles away. A new era had begun.
I guess having all those letters sent to her wasn't enough.
Oh, I didn't see you there. The letters were nice, but I didn't want to pass up an opportunity to see her with my own eyes again.
I don't blame you. Though, after all, who knows when you'd have another opportunity to go out there.
Emily, where have you been?
Oh, I was just chatting with Max. He was telling me about his brother 2908, who had this unique sky spotlight to promote the 400.
Hey, seems like you two have become inseparable.
Yeah, you could say that. I would say more, but I know you gotta get going. Don't want you to miss your path.
Indeed I do. Well, I must be off. I'll be home before you know it.
Stay safe.
Cora?
Steve!
You know something one of my old friends on the CN once told me?
What?
Never give up on yourself, even during the hardest of times. What happens? Happens, and the important thing is to always keep your chin up, because eventually
things will get better. And honestly, after these past few years, I sure am glad he gave me that advice. What do you guys think?
I think that's words of wisdom.
Me too. It's almost perfect.